Hello there, all you beautiful thrill seekers. My name is Coach Shadonk Stubborn, but built for theme parks, and welcome to Coach Chat YouTube channel. Hello there, guys, ladies and gentlemen, thrill seekers of all ages. My name is Coach Shadonk Stubborn, but built for theme parks, and welcome to a very special theme park newsroom discussion video looking at family investments for the future at Thorpe Park Resort. Now, I know a lot of people want this to be a thrill park. However, it looks like they're going in the direction of family, thrill, and long-term resort accommodation, which, you know, we are going to probably do a video looking back on the history of this waterside hotel that's never happened yet in a future video, so stay tuned for that in the future. But for this video, we're looking at three particular sites of investment I could see for the family market. Now, these are family-type rides, and there's going to be some interesting predictions, so stick with me on this one, ladies and gentlemen. Members of the Chal Nation, stick with me on this, because it's going to be a very informative video. Now, before we get started with all of that, make sure you like the video if you loved it. Comment down below your thoughts and opinions on all of this. Subscribe, click the notification bell so you never miss another thrilling YouTube video. Also, guys, check in the description down below where not only can you find links to the Discord server where you, yes, you, the Coast Chal fanbase, can be a part of the Chal Nation by interacting with me on voice chats or on interactive videos in the future. You can also find links to Twitter, TikTok, Instagram, and Snapchat for the channel and personal. And also, you can also find the link to the video ideas submission form on Google Forms where you can submit your video ideas and be shouted out on the channel. And for now, guys, let's talk about family investments for the future at Thorpe Park Resort. So, Thorpe Park Resort have a history of family investments. They were pretty much a family park. For those of you who are watching this, that maybe not even theme park enthusiasts, probably thinking, when did Thorpe Park become a family park? Well, I'll tell you. So when they first opened the park, it was pretty much a family park, and they were growing with family investments each and every time. The first major, shall we say, thrill addition was Logger's Leap, in my opinion. We had things like Space Station Zero, that turned to the Flying Fish, the original one, before a year break, and then it came back in its new location, which is the current location today. But you had the Logger's Leap, you had X No Way Out back in the 90s, and all was going well until the Thorpe Park fire back in the year 2000, when basically there was a fire which demolished the Wicked Witch's Haunt dark ride, formerly known as Phantom Fantasia, and then it was known as Wicked Witch's Haunt for the last years of its operation. And, well, not the last year, the last, you know, couple few years. And basically, Wicked Witch's Haunt burnt to the ground. It was pretty much demolished. It could not be saved. It had to be demolished. And also, it sort of caught fire to the indoor section of Mr. Rabbit's Tropical Travels. Now, that's a water boat ride, which is where Nemesis Inferno is now. Wicked Witch's Haunt is where Detonator bombs away and the whole Angry Birds area is now. And basically, Wicked Witch's Haunt demolished, they brought in a temporary Enterprise ride, and then they sort of brought down their indoor section to the Tropical Travels water ride, water dart ride, slow-moving boat ride, and continued to operate that for another year without the indoor section. And then, from 2001, it was sensory overload on thrill markets, so things like Detonator was brought in, Vortex, the swinging ride in the Lost City area, the Enterprise was made permanent and became Zodiac in a new location, and you know, they were bringing things in future years like Colossus, Nemesis Inferno, Stealth, Flying Fish came back, and there was not really a hint of family investments. There was no real focus on family investments. It was very, very thrill with the cartoony brand that went on for a good few years. Swarm came in 2012, and then 2013 onwards, it became more family orientated. There were still a couple of thrill investments here and there, Darren Brown's Ghost Train, all these different things, and it was mainly family. You know, things like the Angry Birds Land, things like the I'm a Celebrity attraction, things like you know, many different things, many different additions. You know, the Angry Birds 4D, of course, part of the Angry Birds Land, and you know, I think Storm Surge technically was a family ride as well, but they did bring in a lot more family from 2013 onwards, a lot more family investments. Timber Tugboat, the Lumber Jump, the two sort of relocated Weymouth Sea Life attractions, kids attractions, in the Old Town section of the park, And, you know, they did a lot of family stuff from after the Swarm opened in 2012. And it became less of a thrill park and more thrill family. And they sort of wanted to do the resort side of things as well, which is where the Waterside Hotel complex comes into it. So what I'm going to do in this video is share three sites where I could see potential new family thrill attractions. Not really ultimately thrilling, but family thrills. These are family thrills. This is targeted for an all ages audience. So stick with me on this and let's have a look at all the different sites for rumoured family investments that I could see at Thorpe Park Resort, and also what I want to see in terms of family investments at the Thorpe Park Resort. So we begin with site number one. This is the Jungle Escape attraction. This is the current escape room dart ride. Not really open. I don't think it's open at Fright Nights. I don't think it's been open at Fright Nights, but it was open sort of for a few month period. It's not a very permanent building at the minute. After the I'm a Celebrity attraction left the park back in 2019, it was a very temporary building. And overall, it's served its purpose, in my opinion. I do believe it served its purpose. So what I do want to see is that whole building demolished. And I want to see, in terms of what I want to see come into the park on this particular site, you'll see I've circled some grassland. Because, of course, you know, around about behind this attraction, or including this building, was the Miss Hippo's Fungal Safari. You know, this is the old sort of vintage car star ride with the jungle theme. So what I want to see is this building demolished, and I want to see either, there's two potential options here. I'd like to see a sort of splash battle ride format brought in, so some track brought in, so demolish that whole area, and you know, just extend it and sort of have the where the Wilderness Bar and Kitchen or the Huntsman Arms and sort of becomes the station, then you have like a bridge going over the pathway into the station area for the ride. So maybe like a mini splash battle, something like that would be nice, give it a nice jungle theme, something like that. However, the most realistic option I could give this site is to tear the original building down and then extend it and build a brand new, permanent, bigger building and bring in the Garmandale dart ride system. This is the system that you'll recognise that's going to be used in the Gangster Granny ride system for this year, opening at Alton Towers as part of the World of David Williams area in the former Wobble World building in the Cloud Cuckoo Land site. And, you know, this Garmandale dart ride system, physical sets, special effects, moving seats, you know, it's all going to be a nice tracked dart ride system. It's a nice classic tracked dart ride system, and I think overall they can make good use out of that, bringing a jungle theme. I think in terms of theme for the Garmandale dart ride system in this new and improved Jungle Escape building, this extended Jungle Escape building, I could see them bringing the Vulcan Peak theme for it, and sort of make it a more family orientated Vulcan Peak theme for the story of the ride. And I think this would be a wonderful direction for the ride to go into. So I think that's what I'd like to see, either a mini splash battle or extend the building as a new building and bring in this Garmandale dart ride system with a family style Vulcan Peak storyline to the ride, and sort of really make it a nice family dart ride experience. Next up, site number two, and this involves the Flying Fish, Depth Charge, the Amity Beach, Zodiac, Vortex, Quantum's in there as well, and also the actual dome, the big dome entrance to the beginning of the island experience. Now, I reckon this could be a nice themed area to get kicked off in your adventure. You walk straight through the dome and you become part of this massive themed area as soon as you walk into the park. Obviously, you can leave that themed area to the right and sort of go towards the Swarm Island, or you can go down the left side and go towards the likes of Colossus, Walking Dead The Ride, Storm Surge, Darren Brown's Ghost Train, the Dockyard area. However, that Amity Beach area, Flying Fish, Zodiac, Vortex, and Quantum, I'd like to see all of that transformed into its own themed area. Now, whether that's a whole Amity Beach themed area or a water themed area to continue with the Depth Charge theme. However, you've got to look at Poulton's Park, what they've done. They took the Wave Runner attraction, the classic Wave Runner, painted in generic colours, opened back in 2007 at Poulton's Park, and what they've done is they've transformed it into Buffalo Falls, a Wild West theme. Now, one theme I want to see back at Thorpe Park, it hasn't been seen since we've seen the Pirates 4D attraction, you probably guessed it by now, it's a pirate theme. I want to see a pirate-themed area for families as soon as you walk into the park. As soon as you walk through that dome, you're transported. You can see the dockyard, the Swarm Island, and Lost City in the distance with Colossus and everything. But as soon as you walk in, I want you to see this pirate-themed area right across the front as you walk into the park. So the Amity Beach, now whether that means the beach gets removed for a few more attractions, maybe that's the case. Maybe this is where the splash battle comes in. So the beach gets replaced by a splash battle attraction. You take out Wet 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 as well. So Wet 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 and the beach gets replaced by a splash battle attraction. You then, have Depth Charge and re-theme that into a pirate theme. Flying Fish, give that a new pirate theme. The flat rides, Zodiac, Vortex, Quantum. Now, whether Vortex gets relocated somewhere else in the park and rethemed and renamed, or you retheme and rename Vortex, Quantum, and Zodiac all in this pirate area, that'd be nice. There's a million different ways you could do with this. You can retheme the Enterprise, Zodiac, maybe into like you're sitting in your own like mini galleon, like your own mini ship, pirate ship, and you sort of get spun round as if you're going through a whirlpool, and then Vortex is like this ancient treasure the pirates have been trying to dig up for years, and you get spun round as the curse of this treasure takes you for a spin. Quantum, you could retheme that into a galleon, and you're sort of sitting in this galleon, and you get spun around and around vertically, and you sort of become like a flying galleon type attraction. The splash battle, again, you're going to look at battle galleons at Alton Towers to sort of give you a storyline idea, but nothing completely the same as that. Depth Charge, again, this is perfect. Like you're escaping a shipwrecked galleon, and you sort of have to slide down into the rivers below using these little dinghy boats to escape the shipwreck. And again, and there's really a potential here. There's loads of real potential creative opportunities. And with the dome, etc., you could have some characters walking around, different characters from different themed areas to welcome you into the whole experience. So someone representing the jungle, someone representing the dockyard, and a pirate to represent this new pirate area. And I'd like to see maybe multiple pirates on the opening year of this area, and then sort of have those pirates scattered around the rest of the area, and have one or two pirates stay around the dome area to greet the guests. So keep the theme, keep the entertainment, maybe sort of at the outside of the dome, maybe next to Depth Charge on this grass area where it's around near where containment is, but maybe you include containment in the removal as well. Maybe you could see like a stage area, or you sort of next to Depth Charge in that little grass area there, maybe build like a little stage and have like a pirate show every hour or hour and a half and stuff like that. Hour and a half, yar! but yeah, there's real potential here, and I think that there's a real opportunity here to bring that to the park. Maybe not, if it's not a pirate theme, maybe like a nature theme. Maybe you have like the wildest creatures, and you sort of the feel the storyline of the area is that you shrunk down and you turn into a little person, and you sort of you're being dazzled by the giant creatures of the grasslands, and you're sort of going on this nature hike. It's like a nature themed area, and sort of incorporate the landscape of nature into it. So there's real creative opportunities to transform that whole Wet Wet Wet, Amity Beach, Depth Charge, Flying Fish, the Flat Rides, Vortex, Quantum, and Zodiac, and around the dome area to greet you into the area. There's a real potential opportunity to bring in another themed area. I won't go for an IP, but an original idea to bring the family straight into the park from the minute you enter out of the entrance dome. Finally, we have one massive site to go for a family thrill coaster, and this is the Derren Brown's Ghost Train and Walking Dead The Ride building. We don't include Storm Surge in this. We could include Slammer, but I believe there is a deal with Slammer in terms of removing the ride. So basically, you can only remove the Slammer ride if, and only if, Rush is replaced as well. Now, whether that means taking out Rush and bringing in a more updated Screaming Swing system, so it's not part of the original deal, I'm not too sure. However, if Slammer can't be removed because of that, and they don't want to remove it yet, that won't be included. It'll just be the two buildings. Now, the queue line for Walking Dead The Ride would be removed as well. You get a nice open viewing platform of the building, so maybe the exit will be where the Walking Dead The Ride queue is, and the entrance will be where the Darren Brown's Ghost Train queue is. So it's like enter one way, exit another way, and a perfect experience. Now, for this, you have to demolish the Walking Dead The Ride. Unfortunately, you have to demolish it. I think the X isn't coming back, and I think the Walking Dead license ship, the IP of the Walking Dead, is starting to become a bit unpopular. It's starting to become less and less trending, shall we say, and especially with the final season of The Walking Dead coming up, or pretty much on its way, or pretty much already started by the time you're watching this. It's with the final season on its way, or starting, or started, it's going to become less and less a thing once it finally ends, and once The Walking Dead finally goes away and turns into its own spin-offs, etc. It's going to become a less and less popular brand for the UK. So I would much rather see the ride building demolished, and I'd like to see Darren Brown's Ghost Train completely and utterly brought in. And possibly you could even have this Darren Brown's Ghost Train building demolished as well, or extended to include the Walking Dead The Ride building site. So, and with this, look at Movie Park Germany, what they're doing with the Movie Park Studios attraction for this year. This is their brand new intimate multi-dimensional roller coaster past big Hollywood sets, special effects, special elements of the ride experience, and overall the 13 style track in the dark, completely in the dark. I think there's two entry points here and there. I think there's an entrance and an exit point for the outside part of the track with this experience at Movie Park Germany. However, I think that a completely indoor coaster, again, you could sort of pay homage really to both exiting attractions, because you have the coaster element in the dark, which pays homage to Walking Dead The Ride, and you have the Darren Brown's Ghost Train element, which is the dark ride special effects, the live action effects. And I think the big problem with this idea, though, is how can they keep it going? Because you've got to look at Walking Dead The Ride, because of course, and probably Darren Brown's Ghost Train as well, because the Walking Dead The Ride with the live actor edition did not stay very long, and it didn't stay reliable very long, let's be perfectly brutally honest. And with the effects of Darren Brown's Ghost Train, we all know that that ride is very, very unreliable. So it can break down, it can play at 50% or 70% or 30% each and every time. So the reliability with an intimate multidimensional coaster with special effects and some live action during the queue line experience and around the exit of the ride, around the surrounding area as well, that's going to play absolutely key to this attraction. And in terms of themes, again, if they don't go with a pirate theme for the sort of Amity Beach area re-theme, I'd like to see maybe, with this being the dockyard, maybe like an old sea theme, like an old creature theme, like you're being chased by the creature of the Black Lagoon, or something like that, like an original take on the creature from the Black Lagoon. Something like that, maybe, or something sea-related in terms of a horror, like a family horror with the sea creatures. And I'd like to see that maybe come into effect with this particular addition to the park. So, I reckon this is perfect. I reckon this is a perfect addition, and I can't wait to see exactly what could happen with this particular investment at the theme park. So there we go, ladies and gentlemen, thrill seekers of all ages, that is talking about the family investments for the future at Thorpe Park Resort. Now, lots of things to talk about in this video. The Jungle Escape site, the Amity Beach and Dome area, and the Darren Brown's Ghost Train and X No Way Out buildings combined for a multidimensional dark coaster for families and thrill seekers. And I think all of them will bring the family market into a new generation. Now, of course, we can talk about other things as well, like the IPs in the park, which I'm going to save for a separate video in the long-term future this year on the channel. So we're going to talk about in that video Angry Birds, Saw, The Walking Dead, talk about different IPs that they've used in the park, they currently still use, but not even just rides. You know, we can't just keep looking at the rides, we have to look at the IPs in other areas of the park. So things like restaurants, shops, merchandise, how long do these IPs last? So we're going to take a look at all of that in a separate video, but in terms of Angry Birds Land, I mean, I think that'll probably get rethemed at some point. However, I personally believe that we're just looking at the family investments as a as a whole in the future at Thought Park. So looking at three different sites and seeing what they could do. So thank you very much, guys, for watching this particular video from Thought Park Resort. Make sure you're liking the videos, commenting down below your thoughts and opinions. Subscribe, click the notification bell so you never miss a YouTube video. And for now, guys, my name is Coast Chow. Keep living the coast life. And I'll see you guys in the next video very, very soon. Take care, guys. Have a Thorptastic day from the island like no other.